Hello and welcome back to Creative Cat. Subscribe to Creative Cat, press bell icon and select all notification option so you will get notification whenever I upload a new video. My new video is available on my other channel Creative Cat Life. This is the next part of my Niagara visit. Next day we went to this scenic location. Don't forget to check. In today's tutorial, we will make this vibrant, still really elegant texture painting, or you can say an easy hack to make a painting which looks like impasto. I'm using cardboard. Seal the edges using paper. You can use canvas, MDF board or wood instead of cardboard. Make the surface ready for painting by applying primer. I'm using my homemade gesso. You will find tutorial link for gesso in description box. I made this design on paper. You can also get a printout. With the help of carbon paper, I will copy the design on cardboard. So first we'll go the carbon paper, then design stencil, and now I'll trace the design. Texture painting gets made with texture paint, and for impasto you will need thick paints, or you can add impasto paste in paints to make them thick. But here I'm using my homemade gesso. It's thick enough to give texture to painting. I will fill the gesso in a plastic cone just like I show you in 3D outliners tutorial. So my cone is ready. I will put generous amount of gesso on outlines of petals. And now using a paintbrush, I will give texture like real petals. Use firm paintbrush. I'm using oil painting brush. Start from the petals in background. You can test the thickness of gesso. If it's not enough thick, you won't get nice texture. I use plaster of Paris as a base powder in gesso. You can add little more of it to make it thick. You can store this cone for a couple of months in airtight container. Seal the cone opening with tape. You can also use ready-made impasto paste or texture paste and do the same directly with palette knife. Do not make the cone only with plaster of Paris and glue. It will dry in 10-15 minutes. Gesso doesn't dry because it has the third ingredients, paint. Here I'm giving little rough texture in empty spaces with the same gesso. I'm using acrylic paints for painting. Shades are mentioned on the screen as I'm using them. So that was the video, guys. Don't forget to subscribe and give me a thumbs up.